Hi viewers, you are welcome to today's tutorials. In this video, we are going to learn about web browsers and examples of web browsers and their related features or characteristics that help you users to control or manipulate browsers on their computer desktop. Now, what is a web browser? A web browser is a software program that help computer users to surf and search for information over the internet. It also helps users to fetch web pages related content depending on the search or query entered into the address bar of this open browsers or any type of browser you use on your computer desktop. And these browsers have features or characteristics that enable users to control the window of this browsers on their computer desktop. We have the title bar, we have the control box, we have the address bar, we have the file menu, we have the back button, the forward button, the refresh button, and the home page. We will have a practical look at all these browsers, maybe three of them on our computer desktop, and identify the similarities or the similar features that help users to control the window of this browser. Now, we have so many examples of browsers, and we are going to emphasize on some of the common browsers that we use day in and day out. Now, the first example I will talk about is the Microsoft Edge. It's a software or a web browser that comes along with the operating system, and it's used for serving as well. We also have the Netscape, and Netscape is also an example of a web browser. We have the Safari. Those using Mac computers have Safari as their web browser. And we have the Internet Explorer. When you are working with Windows 7, the Internet Explorer is the default browser for Windows 7. We also have the Google Chrome. We have the Mozilla Firefox. And we have the Opera Mini browser. All these are examples of browser that can be used in the computing environment to search and surf for information or to fetch for related web pages over the internet. So these are some of the examples of web browsers. Now we are going to walk through three browsers. We are going to walk through the Opera Mini, the Mozilla Firefox, and Microsoft Edge, and compare and identify all these features that can help you to control browsers on your computer desktop. Now, this is Opera Mini, and we have so many features here. The first feature I'll talk about is the home page, and this area is the home page that contains some thumbnails which are in hyperlink form. When I place my mouse pointer on them, you can see that I have the link select pointer. When I place my mouse pointer on any of these thumbnails, and when you click on it, it's going to lead you to its related web page. So this area you see is the home page of the Opera Mini browser. So this is the first feature we are going to talk about, the home page. Now the next feature I'll talk about is the control box, which is found at the right top corner of the browser window. When you move to the right corner, you can see that we have these buttons. We have the minimize button, we have the restore button, we have the close button. We have four buttons or four commands on the control box. One is between the minimize, the close button, and this restore down. To have the other one, you just have to click on the restore down, and you're going to have the last one, which is the maximize button. So we have four buttons here. We have the minimize, maximize, and at the same position we have the restore. Whenever we click on this, you're going to have the restore done button and also the close button. The minimize button helps you to minimize your program onto the taskbar so that you can easily access your computer desktop and perform any other task or operation. And also we have the restore down. When you click on it, it's going to resize the window so that you can have full control of this window. You can drag the edges both left and right depending on your elevation or your view. Whenever you click on the restore down, it gives you the resize of a window and help you to control the window. When you place your mouse pointer here, this is a search tab. You can click on it to search for tabs or tabs that you are working with. Now the next one is the address bar. The address bar is located below the tabs, and this is the area where we type in our website address or our uniform resource locator, which is going to jump us to its related web page. Try an example by typing www.bean.com here. Now you can see that immediately I type this website address, I have its related home page or web page open within this browser. So that is the function of the address bar. It is the area where you type your address or your URL and you click on search or the enter key, and that is going to jump you to the home page or the web page of the address that is being typed or queried in address bar. So that is also another feature in Opera Mini Browser. The next one is the file menu, which has the icon of the Opera Mini Browser. When I click on this one, I'm going to have so many options here, and where you can choose new tab, new window. You can open a private window of your choice, which will be hidden from other people. You can go to pages and view your web page in full screen. You can print, you can save as, you can zoom in depending on your requirements. When you click on the minus sign, the plus sign, you see that the zooming effect is taking place. You can find certain parameters, you can search, and these are options under the file menu. And if you want to apply any settings, you have to come to the file menu and go to settings. If you need help, you can come here and choose the help from this section. So the file menu is another feature which is part of the Opera Mini Browser. Now the next one I'll talk about is this arrow called the back button or the backward button. This helps you to visit your previous web page. Now when we were in the home page, I typed this URL and I have this page now. So when I click on this back page, when I click on this back arrow, this is going to jump me back to the home page. And the next feature is the forward button. When I click on the forward button, it will bring me to the next page. So these two buttons help you to navigate through your previous and your current web page. The next feature is this one, which is the reload. Whenever you have an information type and it is not well reloaded, you can click on this refresh and it's going to reload and refresh the web page and display any content you are looking for in your open browser. The next one is the home page. Assuming I am in this page and I want to jump back to the starting page, I can just have a one click on this and this will bring me back to the starting page of the Opera Mini Browser. The next feature I also talk about is the search box, and this is the search box. This is where you can search for any information of your choice. You can also search within this, but this is the address bar and this is the search box. They are two different. You type your web address here or your URL, and here you can search for any information. And every browser has its own search engine. They come here and search for any information. So this Google search engine is the default search engine for Opera browser. And if I want to go back, I just go and click on the backward to my watch home page. You also have the scroll bar, which is located here. That can help you to view content. Now you can see that I have this web page which contains text, images, and using this scroll bar, we have the vertical scroll bar. That scroll bar helps you to move right and left within the web page, and the vertical scroll bar helps you to move up and down the web page, so that you can view and identify the right or the important information you are looking for within this particular web page. And that is it. And the next one is I'll talk about is the status bar, which is located at the left bottom corner of the screen. Anytime you hover your mouse pointer on any item, you can see the screen tip at the left bottom corner, and the scroll bar is located at this area. As you can see that there are some text there, so when I go back and over my mouse pointer on this, I can have this status of it, and you select anything, the status bar will give you its information, whether it's an hyperlink or whether it's it will give you the screen tip of it or the notification of whatever item you have what selected within the what the web page, and that is the what the status bar. And also we have tabs here where you can open new tab to have different window within one particular what browser. These are some of the important features of what Opera Mini browser. Let's have Mozilla Firefox open and let's see how it works. It's also at the same thing, has the close button, we have the restore down, we have the minimize. When you restore, is going to resize this window for you. When you click on the maximize, it's going to maximize this for you. When this is also the what the home page of Mozilla Firefox, this is the home page where we have thumbnails that can lead you to their what related what web page when you have a once click on them. And also we have the search box here as compared to Opera Mini, and all these features have similar features that can help you to manipulate the browser window depending on the type of browser you normally use on your desktop. We also have the back or go to back, we have the backward button, we have the forward button, we have the reload as compared to Opera Mini browser, it's the what the refresh. And also if you want to visit your what your home page, just have a once click and this will jump you to your home page. We also have the address bar here, this is the what the address bar, and we have the scroll bar. So let's search for an information here. And hit enter key. Now you are going to have this information displayed. You can use your scroll bar to scroll up and down and find for information that you want. And you can see that the status bar is also displaying information whenever we point to any of this item, and the information is being displayed at the what left bottom corner of the what the screen, as you can see. We also have the tabs here where you can create new tab by clicking on the plus sign to create new tab. If you want to have more than two window open within this browser, you can do it. And this is also the Mozilla Firefox. Let's check the Microsoft Edge. This is also Microsoft Edge, and it's also an example of a web browser. They all have the same information. This is the address bar. You can open tabs here, you can minimize, you can bring it back to your desktop, you can maximize, you can restore your window, you can close the program. And we have the search box here where you can search for information. You can search for any information of your choice, and you're going to get its related what web page, which you can scroll up and down, left and right to view your what your information. And these are the features of what web browsers. We have the backward button or the back button, we have the forward, we have the reload, we have the address bar here, and we have the file menu where you can open new tab here. We have the home page of what Microsoft Edge as compared to Mozilla Firefox. This is the home page, this is the home page, and Opera Mini, this is what the home page. So all these browsers have same features, and if you are able to have control and also identify these features, you can always control your web browser depending on your elevation. And hope this video was helpful, and please give it a like and don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more content. See you in the next tutorials.